Hi, I am Adrian. I am an AI evangelist and inference maker from Intel. Today, I'm going to show you how to build an intelligent queue management application by leveraging OpenVINO and our Edge AI reference kit. By the end of this video, you will understand how this application is created and be able to build your own. And this application can be broken down into two main parts. First, convert and optimize the YOLOv8 model. And second, build and run the queue management application. For each part, we have created a Jupyter notebook and I will walk you through in detail. So let's go to the code. I already cloned the repository and started Jupyter lab environment. So on the left, you see the full repository we have here. There are many scripts, sample video, for example, zones, definition file. But let's enter the docs directory where we have two different notebooks. And the first one is convert and optimize. So we will focus on this first. And the goal of this notebook is to convert YOLOv8 model to OpenVINO and to quantize it. So let's scroll down to the first cell. So first, let's load some sample picture. And this picture is with people standing in the queue. So this will be for sanity checks to be sure that OpenVINO model, YOLOv8 model, they are able to detect people. And so let's load the YOLOv8 model from Ultralytics package. And we decided to use YOLOv8 M means medium, because it's a good trade-off between accuracy and performance. If you need more performance, select, for example, small or nano version. If you need more accuracy, large or extra large. Okay, the model is loaded, so let's run the inference for the first time and see the results. Good, we see that the YOLO model is able to detect people, right? So it would be useful in our application. That's great. Good, let's scroll down. Next, we need to convert the model from PyTorch format to OpenVINO format. And the function export is already available in the Ultralytics package, so we don't have to do much here. And it's already exported, that's good. So we can go to the directory called model, and we see that we have here YOLOv8 OpenVINO model. So we could stop here and use that model in our application. However, we would like to achieve even better performance, so that's why we decided to go with quantization. And quantization is a process to decreasing the precision of the model from a floating point 32 to int 8 to improve the performance, right? Of course, we should expect a little accuracy drop. But talking about my experience, I have never seen more drop than 1%. So I think we can sacrifice just 1% to have much better performance. How much? We will see in a while. Okay, so let's go with the quantization. To quantize the network, we need to provide a representative data set, sometimes called calibration data set or quantization data set. And so we need to provide some data. What data we are going to provide here? Well, the YOLOv8 model was trained on COCO dataset, so we would like to use the same dataset, the validation subset in that case. So let's run the code here. And of course, we need to wait a little bit, right? Because the validation subset from COCO has more than 700 megabytes, so it would take some time to download it. 97, 98, 99, and 100. And of course, we need to download also labels. when it's downloaded, we need to extract them from zip archives. So it should be just a second. Yes, it's done. Good. So let's create a Coco detection data set, and let's create a data loader. We need it for quantization process, of course. Then let's load our OpenVINO model. We already exported to OpenVINO format, right? It's loaded, good. Then let's create the data set in NNCF format, and let's provide some transformation function when we get rid of labels, because we care about images only. Then let's quantize. And here we specify some ignore scope, so we don't want to quantize these operations like multiplication, subtraction, and sigmoid. And of course, some also add operations. Why that? Because we know that ignoring and not quantizing these operations would give us great performance, preserving the accuracy. So if you would like to quantize all operations, it's okay, but you can expect more accuracy drop than ignoring some specific operations. In that case, multiplication, subtraction, and sigmoid. Okay, it's quantizing here in this function. So we provided OpenVINO model here. We provided OpenVINO model, quantization, calibration, representative data set, and we added some preset that we would have mixed precision quantization to preserve the accuracy, and we specified that ignored scoped here, and it's collecting statistics. So from the 300 images from Coco dataset, so we need to wait a little bit, still 20 seconds, and then we will have the stage of biases correction. It should be rather fast, and after that we are able to serialize the model to disk. Serialize means save to disk. When we save the model to disk, we are able to open it in another application and to use it. Good. Statistic collection stage is done, so let's wait for the next stage. Biases correction. Done. Everything is done. However, I have some bonus for you. I would like to show you what's the difference in performance between floating point 32 model and int 8. So let's go to the last section of that notebook, and we will use CPU device in that case, and let's benchmark the first model, I mean OpenVINO floating point 32 model, on CPU with hint latency, because our queue management system is latency system, right? We would like to have the result as soon as possible, so that's why we care about latency. And of course, we will benchmark for 30 seconds, and let's see the result. Let me scroll down to the results. We see that the average latency is 148 milliseconds, what gives us 6.7 frames per second. So it's not very slow, but it's also not very fast, right? So let's compare these results to the int 8 model, which is just one cell below. And so we are doing exactly the same. We are just changed the model to quantized one. And let's scroll down to the results, and now we have 47 milliseconds in average, what gives us 21 frames per second, which is three times faster, right? Just quantizing our network. So that's nice. I like it. Perfect. Good. So we already converted the model from PyTorch format to OpenVINO. We quantized that model to precision, and now it's time to run the application itself. Good, let's go back to the docs directory, then we have one more notebooks, run the application notebook, and here we would like to run the full application, seeing how we can detect people, how we can count people, and how to manage queues intelligently. So let's import some packages. I will run this cell right now. We are importing OpenVINO, of course. We are importing Ultralytics. We are importing also Supervision, because we use some additional packages not to write boilerplate code. So we prefer to use libraries. Okay, letterbox is a part of pre-processing step. So we are we need to pre-process image to have the same ratio, but to be smaller to go into the network. And we have also pre-process function which is calling letterbox function, this one above. And of course we convert the image to type to precision float 32. We also normalize the image, the dividing by 255. We change the order of dimensions, and we create batch with one image. Good. Then we define the post-processing function, because the results from the network are really, really raw, so we need to interpret them somehow. So we do non-maximum suppression, for example. Then we scale boxes back to the original resolution. And we create detections in supervision format. And supervision is a nice library which allows us to detect people only in specific area, like, for example, specific queue. And then we need to initialize OpenVINO. We need to read model from disk. And in this case, it will be a quantized model. But of course, we can use also model in floating point 32 format. Compile model for some device, and if we select auto here, it means that the auto and OpenVINO itself will select the best device for us. So for example, if CPU is available, CPU is selected. If GPU is available, it will be selected as probably the most performant device. And we specify that we care about latency. Yes, because we would like to have the results as soon as possible to be very responsive. And then function to load zones. And what is zone in that case? We have that file called zones.json, and then we specify polygons for our queues. So the first queue consists of 14 points, the second queue has 8 points, and the third queue has polygon with 8 points also. So we load these zones right here in this cell, and then we specify annotators. Annotator is like a GUI. It's graphical user interface. These are these polygons. These are these boxes around people, and so on. So this is just for showing purposes. Then we specify also function for drawing text on the image, because we would like to show the performance we have. We would like also to inform people that the store assistant is required in some specific queue. And then we define the main processing function, where we load our model, OpenVINO model. Then we create a video player. Video player will stream us some input. It could be webcam stream, it can be a video file, so with video player will deliver the frames. Then of course we create these zones for queues, so these areas, annotators, graphical user interface, right? And then we specify people counter. We will count people for all queues. And processing time, yes, we would like to measure and average the time, because That's better approach. Of course, we also can use a video writer to write some output to the external file to see the results after the running this application. And we start our video stream. We in endless loop, we get frame by frame from the player. Then we resize that frame to feed neural network input size. And we measure the time here for three steps, pre-processing, model inference, and post-processing here. And when we have our results, we annotate our zones, right? So we process these results according to each zone. So for example, we filter detections from the full image just to consider only detections which are inside our zone. And zone means specific queue. Then we, of course, draw the boxes around people in that specific zone. We also count how many people we have there. We would like to have stable algorithm, right? So we don't want to flicker like 2-5 people because someone is entering queue and leaving immediately or something like that. So we would like to be sure that in long term we have 3 or 4 or 6 people in the queue to inform the store assistant that someone else is required of this queue. Okay, then we of course draw the information of the image that store assistant is required on some specific cache desk. We calculate main processing time from a few seconds, from a few last frames, draw text on the image about inference time, and write this to the external file showing on the end on the screen at the same time. Okay, so we set the customer limit for 2. So if there are more than 2 people in the queue, we will see the information that the store assistant is required in that queue. So let's run all cells here and let's see the results. Okay, so it's working. We can see 3 queues. The first one is in red, the red polygon and the red boxes around people in the first queue. The second in green and the third, of course, in yellow. And in the top left corner, we see that store assistant is required on cache desk 3 because we see that there are 4 people in this queue and we set the limit for 2. So it works, right? It just works. In the top right corner, we see the inference time, which is 59 milliseconds, what gives us 70 frames per second. Of course, it's a little slower right now because I am recording my screen, so you know it's a heavy task for CPU. When I tested this without the screen recording, I got about 28 or 30 frames per second. So you should expect something like that on your computer. However, of course, it depends on the hardware you have. If you have older hardware, it would be slower. If you have newer hardware than me, it should be faster. But of course, it should be faster than running in PyTorch. In addition to the Jupyter notebooks, we have also created separate Python files, including app, main, and utils, which you can use to deploy the solution more easily. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions or things you would like to share, join our discussions over on GitHub or our Intel community support channel.